Hi, my name is Andrea Giacchetti, and I'm going to present this Shrek 2021 track on skeleton-based hand gesture recognition in the wild. The track is organized by the VIPS Lab of the Department of Computer Science of the University of Verona, in particular by myself, Ariel Caputo, Simone Soso, and Deborah Pintani. Skeleton-based gesture recognition is becoming quite interesting for practical applications due to the availability of cheap and fast hand pose trackers, often integrated also in mixed reality headsets. However, most of the research works proposing new methods for classifying gestures based on this kind of input are only tested on offline benchmarks, dealing only with the pre-segmented gestures classification and not handling the distinction between non-gesture class and gesture classes, and not handling the issues related to false positives. For this reason, we proposed to the participant of the contest the following task. Given a set of labeled training sequences and unlabeled test hand pose sequences, recognize the beginning and the end of the gesture with good accuracy, correctly classifying the gestures, and doing this in an online simulation in order to possibly use the methods to build online recognizer that, like the one shown in this video. For this contest, we build a dataset with 180 gesture sequences in the form of 3D trajectories of hand joints, captured with a lip motion device mounted as in a head-mounted display capture setting. Each sequence features from 3 to 5 gestures interleaved with non-significant motions of the fingers. We developed specific Unity apps for recording the gesture sequences, giving user feedback, and to annotate the gesture more accurately. The dictionary of gestures used for this contest includes three kinds of gestures. Static gestures, like the one shown in the first line, in first row, characterized by a static pose of the hand kept for at least 1 second. The second type is coarse dynamic gestures, characterized by a single trajectory of the whole hand. And the third type of gestures is dynamic fine gestures characterized by the articulations of the fingers. Here are some examples of gestures recorded by our systems and, for example, non-gesture, non-significant hand motions. For the evaluation of our contest, we considered three different metrics. The first is the detection rate. If we consider correctly detected and classified a gesture for which we have an intersection larger than half the length of the ground truth gesture with the detected gestures, and the gestures have the same class label, the detection rate is the percentage of gestures correctly detected over the total number of gestures of a class. The false positive rate is the number of false positives, gestures not corresponding to real gestures, divided by the total number of gestures to be detected. And the Jacquard index measures the overlap between the ground truth labels and the predicted label, considering all the frames and including non-gesture labels. We had several groups registered for the contest, and 4 submitted finally the results. The group 1 is composed by people from the University of Modena and Reggio Emilia and University of Bologna and submitted the results obtained with a transformer network-based method. Group 2 is composed by people from CNR Genoa and submitted the results obtained with an image-based method. The group 3 is from University of Central Florida and proposed the results obtained with 2 different network architectures. Group 4 is composed by people from University of Science, Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam, and propose results obtained with a special templar graph convolutional network. We compared these results also with a baseline, that is a simple dissimilarity-based classifier that we used in a previous work. The method proposed by group 1 is based on transformer networks. It applies a transformer module and then applies a fully connected layer to predict the gesture classes, including also the non-gesture labels to be detected. They use the focal loss for training in order to cope with the difference in the number of examples in training gesture class and non-gesture classes. And they refined the sequences of output labels using a finite state machine. The group proposed three runs that are characterized by mainly by differences in the input features. The input features considered are 640 and are 3D position of the hand joints, joint velocity and acceleration, and joint-to-joint 3D distances. And the three runs have different ways of normalizing the input elements. In run one, they used a normalization per instance in order to obtain a per axis zero mean and unit variance only for position. In run two, they also normalized by the hand size. In run three, they performed the normalization with zero mean and unit variance also for the other features. The method proposed by group two is based on rendering of images from the skeletons. They projected the skeletons on the XY plane and rendered images and used a convolutional neural network to classify the sequences. They used in the first run one method that derived from a previous work of the group using ResNet 50 for classification of the rendered images. And in the second method, they used 3D convolutions, used the ResNet 3D to process the whole volume with the data. The good point of the method is that with the image convolution, they could exploit all the methods available for transfer learning and the use of methods for data augmentations. Use progressive resizing to optimize network convergences to have fastest result. Group three proposed two completely different network architectures. The first is a well-known UDIP-GRU that exploits the current neural networks and unidirectional gate recurrent units as main building block. And it is also the method that performed the best in a previous online gesture recognition contest to be organized in 2019, in which we had to recognize only simple two-dimensional gestures characterized by coarse trajectories. In this contest, the group proposed also a completely different method based on temporal shift modules instead of gate recurrent units, replacing gate recurrent units with these modules that only replace half of the features of the current frame with those of the past five frames. In both cases, authors do not add post-processing to refine the classifications of the frame in order to, for example, have more coherent outputs. The group submitted three runs, the first obtained with an example of 10 UDIP-GRU models, the second using a single TSGR trained model, and the third using an ensemble of these TSGR models. Finally, group four proposed a special temporal method based on spatiotemporal graph convolutional network, adding also a method for gesture detection based on gesture energy, measuring the global motion of the hand joints. For the online classification, they used a sliding window approach as in baseline. But of course, they performed the segmentation with the energy module and the classification using this two-dimensional convolution of the GCN. They also proposed a very simple classifier that can be added and ensembled with a basic method that is used to disambiguate a few classes of gestures like circle, cross, and V, and based and an eye, and based on a histogram of gradients of the 2D projected trajectory. At the end, the group four submitted three results, one based on the single STGCN model, the second based on multiple STGCN models, and the third based on multiple models with also the combination with this simple gradient-based classifier. So let's come to the results. We see that the best results are clearly obtained by group four. even if the results, for example, of group three and then group one are not bad. But of course, they are far from being usable in an online application, especially because of the high false positive rate, making the method detects erroneously a lot of gestures, and that this is not acceptable in a practical application. Most methods are fast enough to work on real time, at least the group three methods from group three baseline and group four. If we look at the performance obtained on the different classes, we see that the kind of gesture is particularly important because static gestures are well detected and classified by many methods, while dynamic gestures not. And even the best methods are not able to classify in a reliable way all the gestures, gesture classes, for example, tap or pointing or left are not well recognized even by the best methods. If we look at the false positive rate, we see that some methods that perform sufficiently well with that has a sufficiently good detection rate are not usable in the practice due to the high number of false positive. In general, methods of group four have the smallest number of false positives. And of course, there are large differences between static gestures and dynamic gestures. The Jacquard index is quite similar visually with respect to detection rate. And this result show that probably it is very important to have some kind of filtering of the gesture, like the detection module proposed by group four, that it seems to reduce effectively the number of false positives. We have seen that some dynamic gestures are very difficult to be recognized, and a good idea could be to develop a practical application trying to avoid this kind of ambiguous gestures that are not well recognized, or to develop specific classifiers for this kind of gestures. An interesting point is that the methods proposed by different groups cover a lot of the different architectures, network architectures proposed in the literature for skeleton-based gesture recognition. And it seems here that the graph convolutional methods is the one performing best, even if it is necessary to decouple the effect of the network architecture from the effect of the detection modules. But it seems that probably there is also an advantage of the architecture related to the improved ability in the recognition of the fine gestures, because, for example, it's as we see in the figure here, the methods by group four are the only one that perform well also on dynamic fine gestures. So these results show also that there is a lot of room for future research in these fields, because there are many more architectures that are not being tested on this online setting and should be customized to work on this online setting. And surely it is interesting to investigate on better modules that can improve the ability of the segmentation modules proposed here to remove false positives. It is interesting to develop optimized dictionaries to avoid any kind of ambiguity. It may be interesting to develop an ensemble of class-specific or gesture-type-specific recognizers to improve the performances, as well as to try to be to develop methods requiring low computational cost in order to implement them for example, low-end hardware like standalone head-mounted displays. And one interesting evolution could be also to use methods of this kind to recognize atomic gestures, and then use other approaches to recognize sequences of basic gestures that can be used, for example, for sign language recognition and so on. Thank you very much. And now it's time for questions. Thanks again.